Hey guys, welcome back to CyberGeek. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to install Go language in Kali Linux. If you guys want to watch this video in Hindi, please go to Hacking Phantom channel, which link I have left in description box and in the I button too. अगर आपको ये वीडियो हिंदी में देखना है तो आप इसे Hacking Phantom channel पर देख सकते हैं. लिंक मैंने डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स और आई बटन पर दे दिया. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द वीडियो. So the question comes here, why we need Go language in Kali Linux, right? Why do we even need it? So let me answer you is that there are certain tools which you need to run it because it uses Go extensions over there, which means Go language. Okay, so you can still run these extensions, but you will get errors. You can still download them in your Kali Linux, but you cannot execute them because they will give you errors all the time. Okay, so today we are going to see how can you install Go language in your Kali Linux. So as coming over here, now you can see, let me just maximize this one. So now you can see the step number one. You have to click on the link. Once you click on the link over here, you can see feature downloads. You have to click on Linux and you have to download this folder, which is of 118 MB. Okay, so I have already downloaded this, so let's just go back. So what you have to do once you download, you can see the second step says download the latest version for Linux over here. So we have already installed, so no need to go to steps two. Let's just go to step three. So basically what you have to do, let me just bring it over here, let me minimize, let me open my terminal and let me do a bit of arrangement. Now, as the step three says over here, let me just bring. Now step three says is that open your terminal and navigate to your download folder. So the command is already been given over there. So I'm simply gonna copy and paste and I'll be inside my download folder, ls. Now you can see the downloaded Go file over there. Right, you can see this over here, Go 1.14.4 Linux AMD 64.tar.z. So this is a zip file. So how you have to extract from the zip file, for that you have to go to command number from in the browser, copy this command and paste it inside your terminal and hit enter. Now you can see over here, error is not recoverable existing now. So which means is that I have been already extract and I have tested it. So for me, it's giving like this. For you guys, it will not give any error, something like that. So let me just clear it now and let me type ls. Now you can see over here, the Go tar is there, right? So just leave it as it is. Do not touch anything in the terminal. Now you can see on the web browser, add variables to Go by modifying. Okay, so we're gonna copy this one. Insert it, hit enter. So we are going to come inside the Vim. So over here, what you have to do, you have to scroll down and you will see there will be, let me just remove them, okay? Okay, so you can see I want to remove them, but I cannot do it anything because it is not in the readable and writable format right now. So to make it into read and write format, you have to type left, shift and I. So now you can see below, right, insert. So what I have to do, let me just remove them. What just happened? Okay. I just selected it by mistakenly. Okay, so let me just remove this one, which means delete. Now you can see for you guys, it will look like something like this. So what you have to do, come down, right? Hit enter. Copy these three commands, which is given over here, which is nothing but your path. It will set all your path so that you can execute Go files from anywhere you like. So I'm gonna insert it over here. These three commands, and then what you have to press is that you have to press escape, okay, left shift and your colon, which is your colon symbol, right, colon, and you have to give W so that you can write, which means save it, right, what you have written. Now you have to come out from this file, then you have to give the same command skip left shift colon, and then you have to mention Q and hit enter. So now you will be outside of the folder over here. Our path has been set. Now what you have to go, you have to go to the sixth command, which says now we need to refresh the bash rc to get update variables. So we're gonna refresh that one, whatever variables we have mentioned inside, right? So we're gonna refresh that so that we can get it. So once you hit enter, everything has been done. So once it is done, you have to come to the seventh line, which says now we're gonna need to verify that everything is correct configured, and we can do that by creating a simple hello world program. Just like your C program, you write a C program when you start for the beginner, right? Hello program, print hello world, something like that. So it's the same way we are going to write a program right now. We don't have to write, it's already given, so we're gonna copy and paste it, and we're gonna check whether it is working or not. So it is working, which means your Go language has been installed in Kali Linux successfully. So let me just copy this one and insert it and hit enter. Now you can see I have the command already, right? And if I try to delete it, it cannot move because I have not enabled the read and write format. For that you have to click shift and I. So now I can insert it, right? So I can simply delete them. So now I'm gonna copy the code which is given over there from the browser, copy and insert. Now you can see it has been inserted. Now we have to save it. For that you have to press escape left shift colon w enter. Okay, it is written, so we have to quit, same command. So once we are quit, we will be outside, and you can see the line below says then save the file and try to run the program. So we're gonna copy this command to go, okay, and paste it over here. Now it says go run. Go run is nothing but it is your executable command. Now what you want to execute, you want to execute the hello world.go file. So hit enter. So now you can see it printed hello world, which means our program runs successfully. Okay, so now you might be thinking that I am only checking the download folder, who knows if it is, might not be working. So let's go outside of it. Okay, let's go outside. Let me just clear it. Let me go to my desktop folder right now. Okay, I'm inside my desktop folder. You can see ls over here, all these stuff. So I'm going to create the file name over here. Now I'm gonna write vim, and I'm gonna write what should I give my first go. No, this is a very long name. Let me just write go program. Go program over here, and you have to give the extension, do not forget .go, and hit enter. Now your file has been created, new file, you can see over here, right? .go with an extension. Now you have to paste the same code to check it, because I don't know how to write a code in Go language right now. I have never learned it. I know only in C, C++, Java or Python. So once you are done, insert it. So over here, we're not gonna print hello world. Go. Okay, so we have already inserted. Now we are gonna save it, W and Q outside. So we have saved it. So how do we execute this one, right? So what you have to do, you have to go and type go run. So what do you wanna execute? You wanna execute the go program. So you can write the name, hit enter, and just wait a bit. And you can see go successfully installed. Our print message has been shown up on the screen, which means Go language has been installed. Now, what is the motive of installing Go language in this video? Is that in when I'm gonna bring the next video, in that I'm gonna show you guys how to install Genix, evil Genix. Okay, in that we're gonna need the .go extension to execute those files. So I hope you have learned something new in today's video, and we will meet in the next video, guys. Till then, goodbye.